Hello everybody, myself is Surjit Akre. I am the first Indian artist who has achieved a postgraduate degree from the Academy of Arts, Repin Institute of Painting, Sculpture and Architecture in St. Petersburg, Russia. I am also the founder president of the Red Heart Club affiliated to Russian Center of Science and Culture, New Delhi. I have an experience of 40 years as a professional artist. You can see through viewfinder. This is a small piece of paper which I have cut according to my form of painting. To see through this viewfinder, it is easier to imagine now what is your focal point and which are the forms you will include in the composition. Make sure all your art materials are closer to hand and start making some marks. Take a good look around you until you see something that captures your eye, perhaps an interesting building or a group of people or flowers twisting tree. Once you have sketched out a few ideas for composition, you are ready to begin sketching outdoor. When you have found it, do some quick thumbnail sketches to help you plan your composition. It will help you create a better sketch. If you have your cell phone or a camera with you, you can use this as a handy way of framing your subject. You can make small sketches first. Draws out the basic shapes of the composition. Now I will start to draw final composition on canvas pad. I will use small size flat brush to make this sketch. To start, take any dark color without water, use thick color and put the points of your forms and then make the contour of the forms. You don't need all the details to draw. I like to use brush as it doesn't smudge all that much and is giving very smooth lines. When you are happy with your drawing, we can then begin to paint in light and dark. I start to paint from the main point. We will apply the warm shade of Indian Red. Mix some yellow ochre to make the warmer shade. The sun shadow makes the color more warm. Apply warm patch. Now apply grey patch at the upper side of the pot. Starting from the left side, I continue this long patch to the right side of the pot. Make the thin line in the center of the pot. Use flood paint. Hold your brush loosely towards the end of the handle and draw lines with a flood movement. The line gets thinner as you drag your paintbrush. Make a tint of light green by mixing the viridian green and lemon yellow. Apply at the foreground bushes. This is the complementary to red shade, so gives very beautiful impression. Now take green and paint front long patch in bottom of the plant. When learning how to sketch, it is always good to plan out some rough ideas first. Try and think about perspective and the golden ratio. This is where you divide your composition up into sections as in the illustration above. Apply the same green on the pot by using stippling technique. Stippling is the brush technique that uses random small dots or scattered brush marks to create color, tones and textures. Then I take a mixture of white green and begin to block in the pot. I take some of the creamy pink color and paint over the still wet in the pot to create the reflections of the water. You can paint each tiny dot of color in a controlled way with a small brush, or you can use a flat, bigger brush and let the bristle make the dots for you. Making separate dots with a brush, with a small brush, hold the brush perpendicular to the surface and make each dot evenly spaced without pressing too hard. paint can be quite flat but not runny. You can experiment by intermixing two or more colors, graduating from one color to another, and applying a stipple over different colored washes. You can also experiment using semi-liquid paint and see the different effects that you can achieve. Then I take some of the pre-mixed Indian red, add a bit of white and green to cool it, and paint in the reflections of the pot of the water. Again, I am not covering the ground completely here, allowing some of it to shine through. We are mixing a dark green to indicate the center of the composition. Look how freely I apply the different strokes, and a beautiful bright warm pink made up of Indian red and yellow ochre brighten up the background and gives the contrast near the focal point. At the back of the center point, for the darkest dark of the block, we are using straight burnt umber mixed with green. In certain areas of the pot, we will apply a thinner, more watery mix of paint to allow the yellow ochre under painting to shine through, giving the pot beautiful glow. Make the tint of red shade, apply near the thumb. You will notice that in certain spots I have paint application thinner than others. This is done purposely to allow the warm glow of the underpainting to shine through. Now begins to block in the background of the painting using color. In certain areas of the background, apply a thinner, more watery mix of paint to allow the yellow ochre under painting to shine through, giving a beautiful glow. Outdoor sketching can greatly improve your skills or observation and getting art ideas down quickly. And getting art ideas down quickly. You will find you get a sense of energy in your sketches that's often difficult to capture when sketching indoors. And hopefully this will add an extra element to your finished painting. Now for the brightest area of the painting near the focal point where the sun is shining, I use titanium white. We will begin by blocking in the creamy pinkish color that was mixed previously. We will apply this mostly towards the horizon of the picture and a bit at the top of background. Again, we are using our brush and to blend and soften edges. We are applying light shade of yellow by mixing the white at the back of the pot. Continue this batch right side. Patch dark shade of dull grayish green apply at the right side. The same color will apply at the background window. This patch will help to balance the composition. begins by blocking in the creamy pinkish color that was mixed previously. Apply this color at the left side corner. Again, I am using dark shade at the contour of the thumb. When you are making the outdoor sketch, you have to keep in mind the harmony and balance in color. Give the depth on the pot. Apply the dark tone of the red. Take a round brush and apply light shade of red by mixing white in it. Give the dimension at the foreground by putting the dark patch of the green at the foreground. Take the small round brush and make the contour of the right side shape. Sometimes it is good to try something unplanned. It may give beautiful result. Make the tint of light mud color. Mix Indian red, green and white. When you want to use dull and muddy color, you have to be very careful. To use the dull color, you must have the practice and knowledge. Otherwise, you can spoil your painting very easily. Then make darker shade and apply in the foreground. six viridian green and white, make the light shade and apply here. Some depth should be also have to given in this part. Make a grey tone and apply here. Make the edges sharp with dark green here. Now dark green patch should have to be given at the left side of the foreground. Give the corner dark shade with brown. At the background, you have to give some depth. Give some details in the window. Thank you. give the contrast near the focal point. Make the contrast here. Dark shade of the brown apply in the window. give some dark green patches at the background, which will give the dimension. Make a shade of light green and apply at the left side of the thumb. At the right side, apply muddy color. Here the left side edges will be sharp and the right side will be softer. Give shadows at the main point. At the right side, put the light with pure white. This is the final part of this series on creating an acrylic landscape painting.